after the whistle, round 7, FFA Cup. Jeff, what a vibe back here in the change room. How do you explain today's performance? Besides just, I'm sick of saying dominating, but it's dominating, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. I mean, I think first and foremost, like you said, the vibe's unbelievable. You know, this is what, the start of the season, you set yourself some goals, and one of the goals that we set ourselves was to get to the last 32, and, you know, we've achieved that goal, which is a big credit to, you know, everyone, you know, the board, the players, the coaches, putting all the effort in, and the support crew, so it's great to get that. I mean, in regards to the performance, I think, yeah, we did dominate the game. I think, you know, there was, you know, started off maybe a little bit just getting into the game, trying to find our groove a little bit in regards to breaking them down. But I think once we got that first goal, we started to really find some opportunities.
But Jeff, look, we pretty much knew they're going to sit back anyway, put as many men behind the ball, try and get a counter attack. That's pretty much what a lot of teams try and do at the moment in the NPL. That's how they feel that that's the tactic that they need to do to beat us. But it obviously didn't work today. And we made a few changes as well to the lineup, and that's still consistent.
Yeah, 100%. You know, we've got a squad for a reason. And, you know, at the start of the season, we put that together because we wanted to go this deep in regards to FFA Cup, the league, you know, Doherty Cup, these types of things. And to be able to maintain the level that we want to play at, we've got to use the squad, you know. And it's credit to the boys that haven't had the opportunity that they might have liked in the league. They got an opportunity today and they came out, they brought some energy, they played well, and they did a good job for us.
After the whistle, my name is Branson Gibson. I'm here with Joey Katavian. Joey, mate, FFA Cup bound, round of 32, here we come. How are you feeling?
Yeah, good. Very good. It's where we wanted to get. That was the aim for tonight, and we performed well, and yeah, can't ask for more.
Were there any nerves going into this one? I mean, so close, we missed out in 2019. It had to be a goal before the season. You're coming up against Pasco Vale, NPL2. Were there any nerves there, or were you just confident all the way through?
Bit of both. We're always confident going into every game, and got to respect Pasco Vale. They're absolutely dominating the second division. So, yeah, like I said, gave them a bunch of respect. But like I said before, we're confident going into games and we played really well.
Jeff, that, you know, when I look at the squad today in particular, everyone's coming off the bench, coming on, finishing the game for us. It is not just a culmination of one good season. It's a few years of hard work from the backroom staff, that's including yourself as well as board members and stuff like that, to create a squad. This doesn't happen overnight.
No, I think you're right. I think, you know, 2019, even, you know, probably from 2017, I think we've been building in regards to, you know, where we're getting to with some consistency at the moment. I think 2019, we were really disappointed that we had great opportunities to win something and we didn't take them. And I think we're starting to see the maturity of this group of players and keeping them together and them being able to, you know, have that belief that they can win anything. You know, whatever the situation might be, they went 1-0 down against Bentley. You know, they came out 3-1 on top. So I think, like you said, it's taken a while just to do it, but I think it's starting to come together. But at the same time, we haven't won anything yet.
Not yet.
You know, and we've got to keep grounded and keep working hard and just keep, you know, week by week, just keep building.
So big stage now, round of 32, chance to take on A-League opposition as well. How much are you looking forward to a chance to play on such a massive occasion?
Oh, always looking forward to it. We've got a great bunch of boys here. We've got a fit bunch of lads at the moment and everyone's itching to play. And yeah, what better to go up against an A-League team and give them a red hot crack?
How far are we going to go, mate?
Look, you say we can go all the way. The way we're performing this year, we're fit, we got numbers, we can go all the way. But it's you know, they're one-off games. Anything can happen, you know. We took Sydney to extra time a few years back and that was a great run. But yeah, we don't set a limit. We want to go all the way.
Jeff, Stefan Valentini goes to me, "Where's the round of 32 flag?" And I said to him, "Don't worry about the 32 flag. Worry about it when we're holding a semi-final flag or a final flag. That's what's really, really important." How much faith do you have in the boys to go, yes, this was the goal, last 32, right? But now we're thinking, you know what? We can do quarters. We can do this. I mean, gonna get 16 as well, obviously, but can we do it?
100%, you know, I think we've got a fantastic squad. You know, really technical players. I think we're confident confident that we can take it to anyone, you know, whoever the opposition is. But, you know, we'll look forward to the draw and we'll take it one game at a time. And
now, last time I checked, there was 0-0 with Oakley and South. That's going to be a tight game. Tell me it doesn't feel good when you see two NPL teams struggling. And maybe they went to extra time. I don't know. I haven't checked the results, so don't hold me against it. But let's say they go to extra time. You're hoping that'll tie the legs out come this weekend, right?
Yeah, we don't play either team, so it's not going to favour us. But it's obviously a tough game for both of those teams. So, yeah, we'll see what happens.
You were part of the club in 2018. As you said, when we took on Sydney FC, what can you learn from that sort of journey? Because a lot of the players that we still have were part of that group. That's got to be beneficial, right?
Yeah, of course. We've been together for, you know, 4 or 5 years now. And we've got, I'd say, one of the tightest groups in the NPL. And we've got that camaraderie in the change room. We take that out onto the pitch, and it shows in our performance and our belief lately. But yeah, I reckon, yeah, versus an A-League team will be quality.
Who do you want to face next round? Do you think about that?
Nah, not really. Just take it as it comes. You know, we watch the draw when it's done, and you know, we chuck it in the chat, and then we go from there.
Fantastic. Well, congratulations. See you in the round of 32, mate.
Thanks,
well done.
Appreciate it, mate. Thank you.
Jeppa, look, congratulations again on behalf of all the fans out there. It's such a joy to watch this team, and a lot of credit goes to you guys, the staff that get these guys ready every week in and week out. And so we appreciate the good work, and here's the just rewards, the round of 32 FFA Cup.
Thank you, Tom.